Hello, today we're going to talk about continental drift. By the end of these notes, you should be able to answer the question, what evidence supports that the continents have moved? Let's start with vocabulary. Continental drift is the slow movement of the continents over the surface of the Earth. A continent is a large landmass, such as Africa, South America, Australia, and so on. You can't talk about continental drift without talking about Alfred Wegener, who developed the theory of continental drift and the previous existence of a supercontinent called Pangaea. The idea that the continents were once together was not new, but Alfred Wegener provided more evidence than those before him. He presented not only geographical evidence, but fossil evidence and paleoclimate evidence. At the time, however, Alfred Wegener could not answer the question how or why the continents were moving. That information was not available in the 1910s. However, by the 1960s, his theory of continental drift was widely accepted and could be explained through plate tectonics. Let's go over some specific evidence that supports continental drift. This includes continent shape match, fossil match, mineral and oil match, paleoclimate evidence, and seafloor spreading. Let's go over shape and fossil match evidence. The continent shapes match. South America and Africa, if put together, have matching shapes, but this is weak evidence at best. However, we also have matching plant fossils and animal fossils. We have identical land animal fossils on both South America and Africa. The same is true for some plant fossils. Now when you line up the continents, not only the shapes match, but the positions of the fossils also match as well. This is strong evidence since plants and land animals can't cross the ocean, supporting the idea that the continents were likely connected in the past. Now let's move on to shape and resource match evidence, particularly diamond and oil deposits. There are diamond and oil deposits all along the coast of South America and Africa. When we line up the continents, not only do the shapes match, but the locations of the deposits also match as well. This is strong evidence since the diamond and oil deposits are identical in age and composition. This could have only happened if the deposits were created at the same time location when the continents were together. Let's go over the paleoclimate evidence. Glaciers push away till, a mix of rocks, as they expand. Glaciers also leave striations, which are parallel scratches on rock. A glacier that would have formed when all the continents were together would have left striations and till behind. Currently, most continents are not covered in glacial ice. However, striations and tillite, a sedimentary rock made from till, have been found on separate continents. This means the continents were once covered in glacial ice. Striation patterns and tillite deposits outline the edge of a glacier when the continents are joined together. Lastly, let's look at seafloor spreading, which is the mechanism that creates new rock between the continents as they separate. That means the ocean floor has the newest rock at the ridge. Additionally, the ocean floor has identical patterns in magnetism caused by the reversing of the North and South Pole, which happens periodically in our Earth's history. Now you should be able to answer the question, what evidence supports that the continents have moved? Till next time, bye!